In today's video, I'm going to be airbrushing the main body on the S100 using oil paint to replicate the wooden deck, improving the overall look of some of the smaller parts, and using a selection of oil based paints to add all the weathering to this S100. So in this video I'm going to be finishing off the S100 that I built back in July last year. It's been sat on my shelf waiting to paint. In this video I'm using quite a lot of different techniques, but I wanted to make it really about hand painting. So there is a few sections about airbrushing, but it's mainly focusing on hand painting in today's video. Like I said, you can hear from my throat, I'm still quite suffering with vocal cord issues, so I won't be able to fully overvoice this video. But I've edited it in a way that hopefully you can quite easily follow the steps. And like always, if anybody's got any questions, I'm always open to answer them if you leave them in the comments. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you all again soon. So my original intention, I was going to airbrush the foredeck, but in the end I decided to hand paint it. But I thought I'd still leave in the masking process in, just so you can get a visual representation of how I would have masked it if I was going to airbrush it. in today's video I decided not to list every paint I use and display them on screen, but I went with the main recommendations for the body of the S100 that you get from the Revell kit. I used a few Tamiya different colours just because I didn't have them in the Revell range, but then when you see me using the oil paints, I'm using a range from Winsor & Newton. Thank you. In this section I'm just sealing the ends of the masking tape with some matte varnish, and that's a very good practice to do if you're hand painting. But in the end I decided to, because it was metallic copper, try to just use the airbrush. So with this S100 kit we received some thread that we use. It's a little bit brittle, but I thought I'd try to just make the overall appearance of the life buoys just look a little bit better, and I think I achieved that. whenever you see me using the little cocktail stick to glue in something down, I'm actually using Loctite Super Glue Precision, and I find it one of the best super glues out there for these kind of jobs where you just want that instant grab. It's also very much non-whining. So now I'm just using a basic kitchen sponge. I just want to use a technique of adding a sponge to do some chipping to that main gun plate. So you dip the paint and pretty much take it all off. And then with just the delicate touches, just mostly around the leading edges, just trying to replicate some chips. And this can be one of just the most accurate chipping methods you can do. You can also add it with a little tiny paintbrush, but just chipping with a sponge done right just looks really good. So in this kit there was only a total of actually four decals, just to add. There's two obviously on the body, these two I think the Panthers, and then there was two stickers that went on the display stand. So I don't know how accurate this actually is, but it's something that I saw on a reference picture. It's just highlighting a little bit of the detail on the Panther, and I just thought it just stood out a lot more than just that black Panther. I don't know how accurate it is, and I could be completely wrong, but I just think it looks more visually interesting. Now just moving on to the last section of just weathering. I need some wear and tear, just where things would be knocked and banged. It's added some street marks, and this model will be complete. So if you have any questions about today's build, please leave a comment. I'm very approachable. I'll always try and answer people's comments the best I can. But I say, if you enjoyed today's video, please don't forget to give me a like. If you're not subscribed to the channel already, please subscribe, because I will be doing more plastic models like this. I even probably looking to make the big sister of this, as I really enjoyed this kit. So anyway, thank you all for watching. Until next time, take care.